Hello once again. This lecture is in continuation of the previous video. We are reading Jonathan Swift's essay, The Spider and the Bee. Let us continue with the text. At length, casting his eye upon the bee and wisely gathering causes from events, for they knew each other by sight. After feeling the terrible shaking in his web, the spider comes out and wisely gathering causes from events, for they knew each other by sight. And he encounters bee and understands what has happened. As the spider had known the bee by sight, so he addresses him directly and says, "A plague split you," said he, "for a giddy son of a whore." He is cursing the bee and says, "May a plague split you, may a terrible disease like plague destroy you. For a giddy son of a whore, is it you with a vengeance that have made this litter here?" Litter, the destruction, made his palace dirty. He is asking, why did you made his palace dirty? He is asking to the bee. "Could not you look before you and be damned? Do you think I have nothing else to do but to mend and repair after your ass?" "Could not you?" The spider asks the bee whether you could not have been more careful in going about. "Do you think I have nothing else to do but to mend and repair after your ass?" Do you think that I have nothing else to do except to mend and repair the damage which had been done by you? "Good words, friend," said the bee, having now pruned himself and being disposed to drool. The bee, who has now completely get rid of the threads of the cobwebs and disposed to drool. Disposed to drool means feeling to talk in a joking manner, in a light manner. She replies in a very calm manner, calling the spider, "Good words, friend. I'll give you my hand and word to come near your kennel no more. I was never in such a confounded pickle since I was born." The bee says that in future he would never come near your kennel. Kennel means a dog house. She is comparing the web of the spider to a dog house, by which the bee means that spider's web is a dirty place. It is not a palace. It is like a dog's kennel. So the bee is insulting the spider and its house. "And I was never in such a confounded pickle since I was born." And his experience at his home has been so unpleasant and bad that the bee compares it to a confounded pickle, into an embarrassing situation. And the question of his coming here again did not arise. The bee will not come here again. She gives his word to the spider. "I was born, sirrah," replied the spider, "if it were not for breaking an old custom in our family, never to stir abroad against an enemy, I should come and teach you better manners." Sirrah means sir. Now the spider says, it is an old custom in his family never to come out their palace in order to fight and against an enemy. "I should come and teach you better manners." Otherwise, he would have taught the bee a lesson for the future. "I pray have patience," said the bee, "or you will spend your substance, and for aught I see, you may stand in need of it all toward the repair of your house." The bee then advises the spider to have patience. and or you will spend your substance, your energy, by which the spider makes his web. And for aught I see, you may stand in need of it all toward the repair of your house. She advises him not to exhaust his energy by useless talk, because the spider will need all his energy for carrying out the repairs to his house. "Rogue, rogue," replied the spider, "yet methinks you should have more respect to a person whom all the world allows to be so much your better." Now the spider is scolding the bee for talking in this insulting manner. Spider calls him rogue, and he is scolding the bee and says, "I am such a person who has been recognized by the world as being far superior and better to you, to the bee. Yet methinks you should have more respect to a person whom all the world allows to be so much better." I am much far superior and far better to you, to the bee. "By my troth," said the bee, "the comparison will amount to a very good jest, and you will do me a favor to let me know the reasons that all the world is pleased to use in so hopeful a dispute. "By my truth," the bee says in reply, "that the comparison made by the spider is nothing, just amount to a very good jest, is nothing but a joke." Jest means a joke. "And you will do me a favor to let me know the reasons that all the world is pleased to use in so hopeful a dispute." And the bee then asks on what grounds the spider supposes that the world regards the spider as being superior to the bee. At this, the spider, having swelled himself into the size and posture of a disputant, began his argument in the true spirit of controversy. At this, the spider expands his body with anger in a very aggressive manner and began to argue his case in the true manner of a debater, of a disputant, with resolution to be heartily scurrilous and angry. Scurrilous means abusive. To urge on his own reasons without the least regard to the answers or objections of his opposite. The spider was fully resolved to give answer in strong and abusive language. He was firmly determined to advance his own reasons with much energy, to be heartily scurrilous and angry, to urge on his own reasons without the least regard to the answers or objections of his opposite, without giving any importance or care to the objections of his opposite. His opposite means the bee. And fully predetermined in his mind against all conviction, and fully determined to stick to his own point of view and not to allow himself to be convinced by the arguments of his opponent, the bee. Now, the use of irony here is noteworthy. Irony means the difference between appearance and reality. As this episode of Spider and the Bee is an allegory, and the dispute between the two is representative of the dispute between the ancient and the moderns. So on the surface level, it just seems a quarrel between the two creatures. But in reality, swift through these creatures, where the spider represents the moderns and the bee represents the ancient, is commenting upon the dispute. The spider is determined that he will not allow himself to be convinced by anything that the bee may have to say. What Swift really means is that the moderns in this controversy were determined not to allow themselves to be influenced by the arguments that the ancients might have to offer. Okay, that's all for today's class. I will continue with the remaining part of the essay in the next class. Thank you.